Behold, this scroll without a name. Within it is recounted an as yet unfinished tale. If thy heart be drawn to its contents, take up the scroll and unfurl its aged parchment. I see thou art keen to know more. In that case, allow me to spin for thee a yarn. A tale spanning the history of the ninja. The story of a never-ending chain of battles. Raging ceaselessly since creation itself, before even the days of the Atsutsuki.
Take this!
You missed! Even as ninja formed clans and villages and settled into prosperity. Unfettered did burn the fires of conflict, and hatred did spread its steely grip.
Got you!
Amidst this strife, two warriors faced one another and continued their fight.
Wood style hidden jutsu, he caused emergence.
Summoning jutsu.
My heart dances when fighting you. Madara, why you come? Entertain me more.
Take this!
I'm coming down on you!
Susano!
Now isn't this fun?
You should enjoy yourself more.
Did you think mere trees could stop me? Wait, is that? Now burn for me.
Coming down on you.
You won't be standing there like that.
You're indecisive enough.
Coming down on you.
I'll crush you right here.
You intend to use that blunt old thing against me?
Now burn for me.
What are you doing?
Take.
Perhaps this will tame you somewhat.
Let's see you try and stop this.
You will be standing there like that.
You missed.
Stop this! What's that? Lost your nerve?
Come on!
Saw that coming.
Ninetales!
Attack!
What style? What golem jutsu?
Tailed beast in Susanoo.
I would say we're both plenty warmed up, wouldn't you?
Indeed.
Prepare to fight.
This is why I could never stop fighting.
He's not backing down. To find out who's stronger, Madara. Your nine tails or my wood golem.
As you wish.
Now what will you do, Hashirama? I savor our battle, Hashirama. No one else can match me.
This is what ninja battles should be like.
I don't want to battle you.
You're my friend.
You always were blind to sentimentality. Dare to dream once in a while.
But this isn't over.
Susanoo! Even the almighty Susanoo isn't invincible!
That's as far as you go.
Come on!
I'm going to blow the entire ground away.
Did you think you would put up?
Not quite.
Yes, I stopped him.
This.
Begone, Hashirama.
choice. Sage Art, Wood Style, Shinsu Seishu Veritable Thousand Arm Kanon.
The battle will never end, but still the ninja keep up the fight. They fight for what they believe in, to follow their own true path. And so, time passed. But the cycle of battle never ended. And as the violence of the ninja world continued to grow more severe, two shadows walked down a path. What will they find? And what new path will it lead them toward? In the next chapter, two unparalleled warriors.
The world is going to end here.
Land of Fire, Hidden Leaf Village. Here lives a boy who dreams of becoming the village leader, the Hokage. That boy's name is Naruto Uzumaki. In his body dwell the nine-tailed fox, the mighty-tailed beast that once attacked the village, but the strong will that he was born with allowed him to run down the path of growth. However, there was trouble brewing in the ninja world. An organization known as the Akatsuki had set out to collect the nine-tailed beasts, including the nine tails, and declared war on the ninja world, releasing the flames of a massive conflict. Once they were ignited, the flames continued to burn on. Naruto Uzumaki just kept staring straight ahead. Having forged new bonds, he kept his eyes fixed on the future and let loose a roar. That roar grew stronger and spread. And as if they were echoes, his many allies leapt into action.
Naruto.
All for his sake, as he keeps on fighting.
This world is meaningless now.
Now, time for chaos.
The roars from the splitting earth herald the end. As this battle to save the ninja world enters its final stage. The ultimate deathmatch.
The world no longer needs hope, a future, or any famous heroes.
When this reality ends, all we need is a single endless dream.
I had a dad, a mom, an old male sage. Kids look up to heroes. So I'm gonna keep charging ahead without losing my way. I'm gonna become the best Hokage there's ever been! That's my dream, you idiot!
What should we do, Kakashi?
There's something that won't leave my mind.
Sing with me, Kurama! Tail Beast Planetary Rasen Shuriken!
What is it?
This is still just a hypothesis, but his jutsu may be the same as my Kamui.
What?
If my hypothesis is right, and we're using the same jutsu, then our eyes must be the same. Which means that the space-time dimension that appears must also be the same. If I can use that to our advantage, just wait.
I'll take you all into an easy dream before you know it.
We're not done yet. Time to up the stakes!
Thank you.
Land of Fire, Hidden Leaf Village. There stood a boy whose clan had been eradicated by his own elder brother. A boy by the name of Sasuke Uchiha. He lived for a period of time in peace, but as soon as he began walking down the path of revenge, he slipped into darkness. And finally succeeded in conquering his brother, Itachi Uchiha. But his brother's words had all been lies. The Hidden Leaf was the real enemy. Soon, the tiny flames of hatred grew into the inferno that was the fourth great ninja war. And as the terrible conflict erupted, as he dashed toward the battlefield, Sasuke Uchiha saw someone completely unexpected. His brother had been revived into the physical world. Over time, the two came to terms with each other, and were finally brothers once more. And then, after succeeding in what he came to do, Itachi disappeared into the light.
I will always love you.
Leaving just one line of truth with his little brother.
There you are.
See, it's... And Jugo?
We've been looking all over for you.
So, what do you want with me? Why did you come all this way to find me?
Well, the thing is, we just happened upon a mind-blowing scroll in Orochimaru's hideout. Take a look. Well, pretty amazing, huh?
Yes. They're the ones with all the answers. There's someone I need to see now.
Who's that?
Orochimaru.
Huh? What are you talking about? You iced his ass.
You know Orochimaru. You really think that'd be enough to vanquish him? Jugo, bring that woman too.
Who is she?
The Hidden Leaf ninja Kabuto kidnapped. The seal absorbed Orochimaru's chakra. We'll just use that to summon Orochimaru back.
Whoa, hold on. Reviving Orochimaru is way too dangerous. Huh?
Curse unsealed!
Who thought I'd be resurrected at your hands?
See? What did I tell you? He's gonna attack us now!
Are you still after Sasuke?
Good question.
Right here! Take this!
Think again.
There!
Take this! We're only just getting started, aren't we?
Sasuke, he's just trying to screw with you!
It's over!
Try taking that!
Right here!
There!
It's spacing out!
There!
Inferno style. Susanoo flame control.
Orochimaru, I know what you're thinking.
Burnout.
Feeling better now, Orochimaru? Had enough?
I've limbered up. Yes. That'll do for now. Fighting him made me realize that he's a bit different from before. So,
there's something I want you to do for me, Orochimaru.
Yes, you really don't need to explain all that. I've been watching him the whole time, remember? And when you meet them, then what?
I know too little. I want them to tell me everything.
You needn't trouble yourself with all that. You're still just a child, after all.
No. I'm not a child. Not anymore. I can't be a child. I need to know how it all began. I need to know who I should be. What I should be doing. I want to know everything, so I can decide what it all means for myself. I want to make my own judgments. Then I'll decide what needs to be done.
I think I quite like you now. Very well. I'll help you. Come with me.
Where to?
Oh, to a place you know very well indeed. Come, let's go.
I knew it. But I didn't want to believe it. I wanted to be wrong. I mean, back then, you were a hero.
It was during the Third Great Ninja War. An age when men and women, young and old, anyone who was known as ninja, flew headlong into battle. They drew blood, shed their bonds, stole things, and lost their own. This cycle of hatred spread like wildfire, endlessly. And in the center stood three fledgling youths. They too were ninja. Embroiled in this terrible war, putting their lives on the line.
How are you always so late? Ninja have rules. You need to stick to the plan. A good ninja sticks to the rules and does everything by the book.
Rules, doing things by the book, that's all you ever talk about. Don't you have any compassion?
Any ninja that breaks the rules sullies their name. You can at least understand that, right?
Okay, okay, you two. Give it a rest. We're on the same team, remember?
Rin, you're too soft on Obito. Today's a very important day for us.
Yeah, that's true.
Huh? What's going on?
Phew. Let's talk about it on the way to our destination. As of today, Kakashi's become a jonin, like me. We'll split into two units led by Kakashi and myself in order to give us the best chance of success. We're suffering from the biggest lack of manpower that the Hidden Leaf Village has ever seen. Remember?
Actually, Obito, remember our talk about giving Kakashi a present? I already gave him a medkit, and Sensei's also...
I gave him a custom-made kunai knife. Just like the one I carry.
What about you, Obito?
Sorry, I forgot.
What?
Well, I wasn't expecting anything from you anyway. It probably would have just been a piece of junk. Useless crap like that would just be excess baggage.
Hey!
Oh, come on, don't start fighting!
Now, let me run through the mission. You're all aware that the Land of Earth has launched an invasion against the village hidden in the grass, right?
Yes, they're coming very fast. It's only a matter of time before they cross into the Land of Fire.
That's why we need to stop them as soon as possible. As such, our mission this time is to infiltrate enemy territory and destroy the Kanabi Bridge, which is part of their supply route.
So we're going to cut off the enemy's support network.
What about you, Sensei?
I'm going to tackle them head-on and act as a diversion for you. For today, Kakashi is your leader. We'll stick together until we hit the border, but after that, your unit's on its own.
Okay!
They noticed me, did they? Impressive.
Careful now, everyone. There's 20 of them, although there's a good chance they're using Shadow Clone Jutsu.
I'm going in. Cover me.
Not so fast, Kakashi. You should act as backup.
What about what you said before, Sensei? I'm the leader today. That means I call the shots, doesn't it? That's the rule.
Okay, everyone. Follow Kakashi's lead.
Okay.
That's all there is to it.
I don't like fighting kids. Even if we are at war, it doesn't feel right. The least I can do is make sure you don't suffer.
Poof! Chidori!
You won't escape!
Okay, let's go! Chidori!
Let's go! Damn it. You're tougher than you look.
Got it! Got it! You missed! Okay, let's go! Okay, let's go!
Yeah, the
Sorry.
That blonde guy couldn't be the yellow flash of the leader. No, there's no way.
Okay, let's go. Chidori.
That's the last of them.
Are you okay, Kakashi?
Good. No sign of any reinforcements. Kakashi's really worn out. Let's retreat for now and regroup.
I'm fine.
Fine my ass? That's what you get for ignoring Sensei and doing whatever you like.
That's some talk, coming from a ninja who was too scared to be of any help.
I wasn't scared! It was just, you know, I had a tummy ache. I'll be fine next time.
That's all that ever comes out of your mouth. Excuses.
Enough already, you two. You're going to have to work together from now on if you want to complete your missions. Right now, you're pulling in opposite directions. Yes, Kakashi. Rules in the Ninja Code are important, but they aren't everything. It's like I taught you. Sometimes you've got to adapt to the situation you're in and bend the rules. And Obito, you still haven't truly prepared yourself to be a ninja. Your spirit is weak. That's why you feel scared when you actually face the enemy. I've got faith in you all, though. I know that you can complete this mission on your own. But if you cannot work together and function as a team, you're going to fail. Before I go, one more thing. The most important thing any ninja has to master is teamwork. Got it?
With heartbeats racing, without a clear vision of what was really right and wrong, trapped in a battle with no exit, the boys just kept moving forward, running as fast as they could.
There was all this going on under the leaf shrine.
Now, let's begin. Reaper Death Seal, release! This mask is necessary in order to use the jutsu written in that scroll. Using this calls out the Reaper, which then possesses the user. Then we can release the things that were sealed by the Reaper. Jugo, Sasuke, Suigetsu, get ready! Now, Jugo. Use your chakra to make the extraction from Sasuke. That should draw out the spores of the Zetsu that Tobi set as Sasuke's watchdog. They'll serve as the sacrifices to summon the Four. Reanimation Jutsu! The ones who know everything. The former Hokage!
The first Hokage? Hashirama Senju, feared as the god of all ninja in the flesh.
What's going on here?
The Reaper Death Seal. They must have released it somehow. And then used reanimation.
Looks like we've been brought back to life, First Hokage.
Reanimation again? Everyone seems to have no trouble using the jutsu I invented.
There's a reason for this. I simply prepared all this to grant his wishes.
My name is Sasuke Uchiha. I have some questions for you, Hokage.
What? Sasuke?
First of all, third, why did you make my brother do what he did?
I see. So you know.
I still want to hear it from your mouth. Everything about Itachi.
He killed his fellow clan members and stopped a coup. The man single-handedly prevented a war. He even installed himself in the Akatsuki as a spy after that, to keep the village safe. All under the condition that I protect you, his younger brother.
So it was really true. Now, first, I ask you, what is the village? What does it mean to be a ninja? Itachi, my brother, was prepared to protect the Hidden Leaf with his life, despite knowing he'd been used by the village, and he was proud to be a shinobi of the Leaf. What does it mean to give up your own life to protect a village? And what about the ninja that creates such a situation and believe that it's okay? I want to hear it from you. I want to hear the truth so I can decide for myself. Should I take revenge on the village, or...
Revenge on the village? You think I'm just going to let you...
Tobirama! Lower your hand.
Fine.
Well, excuse me. Well, you want to know about the village, you say? I'd be glad to tell you what you want to know, but it might take some time.
No. Please just tell the boy what he wants to know as quickly as possible. What do you mean? We're in the middle of a war here. Madara Uchiha has come back to life and is trying to destroy every last ninja in the world.
Yes, I can sense a powerful chakra presence at 2 o'clock.
The second Hokage is right. I'm picking up some intense chakra too. But it's not just that. No, I think... this feeling. Naruto, you're fighting too, aren't you?
If Madara's back, talking will have to wait. We can't afford to sit around here and do nothing. I'm sorry, but if you want to head to the battlefield, I must insist we finish our conversation first. If you can't provide Sasuke with the answers he desires, I wouldn't put it past him to use you all to destroy the Hidden Leaf. Damn you, Orochimaru.
Don't worry, Orochimaru. We understand. Our first priority should be finding a way to ease up what's binding him. So, where should I begin? Well, in order to explain what a village and a ninja are, I must first explain about the two clans, the Uchiha and the Senju. We fought and fought. Both of us were at the very end of our ropes. And we both knew the end had to be in sight for one of us.
Madara,
you.
There is nothing that you say. It's only battle.
You're strong, Madara. You always were. But I have to protect the village at all costs. I can't let you beat me.
Take this.
My village, not my ninja.
Take this.
We're coming down on you.
Too weak.
Take this.
What are you doing?
Too weak. Madara, why? It's over, Madara.
Then finish me. Can't do it. That is your problem, Hashirama. You're soft.
I'll do anything to protect our... No, to protect my village, no matter what happens. I believe that protecting the village means protecting the people of the Hidden Leaf. The ninja, the children. I don't care who it is, my friend, my brother, or my own child. I won't forgive anyone who threatens it.
You have your priorities mixed up. That will create darkness in the village. Someday.
That's when I found my resolve. My resolve to protect the village to the bitter end. I don't know how he resurrected himself now, but I buried my friend for good that day, for the sake of the village. Which brings me to the village itself. What Madara and I envisioned at first was a place for clans to come together and connect. A way to bring order out of chaos, and keep it that way. It was a place where our children could be safe, where no pointless battles were fought, a place of peace. But the fact is, it created a darkness like the one that your brother Itachi bore. Perhaps Madara was right. Perhaps he saw all that coming. I'm the one who created that situation. I'm the only one who gave it the okay. You see, to me, a ninja is someone who bears anything necessary to achieve his goal. However, a ninja is also shaped by what sort of goal he strives for. Just like Madara and I.
A ninja is someone who bears whatever it takes to reach his goal.
That's what I built the village on. But Madara had a different ideal. I don't know about Madara's current resurrection. I don't know what's behind this idea of his to wipe out the world's ninja, but...
Infinite Tsukuyomi. Regardless of clan, creed, country, or anything, he wants to trap everyone in a genjutsu so he can make things happen exactly as he desires. Everything my brother and you fought so hard to protect, he wants to destroy it all.
Then we can't afford to stay here a moment longer.
Now that you've heard the first Hokage's explanation, what do you intend to do with it? Will you turn your blade toward the hidden leaf? Or...
Sasuke. Forgive me. I always lied to you. I asked you to forgive me, even as I kept pushing you away. I didn't want to pull you in. But now I think of it this way. Maybe you could have changed father, mother, the Uchiha clan, if I'd faced you honestly from the very beginning. If we'd told each other the truth as equals. I failed. I won't put myself above you and tell you this and that. It's too late. So this time, for once, let me tell you one small truth. It's all right if you never forgive me. But, no matter what you become, I will always love you.
I'm going into battle. The village, Itachi. I won't let it all be in vain.
Well said. Come then, there's no time to lose.
So, that's the path you've chosen. Now, show me what you're capable of. Sasuke Uchiha. Your new wind.
Talked about here when we were kids.
Yes. Although at the time, I really thought you were joking.
How cold. I'm not the kind of man who makes a joke about something like that.
You really were a strange one, though. What was it now? A school for the children? A safe village for your brothers? I remember thinking that you had some pretty grand plans for a little kid.
Oh?
But they weren't bad dreams. They were the same as mine. which is why I am here with you today.
Yes.
The Hidden Leaf Village. This village has become precious to me, and I must protect it.
So, have you thought about my Hokage idea some more?
What? You are being serious about that? I thought you were just pulling my leg.
What? No, I was being deadly serious. You would be perfect for the position. You'll be the leader of the village and guide everyone forward. And we'll carve a model of your face in the cliff here as an emblem of the village.
Hey, I never agreed to that. It's not my style.
It's not up to you. The more embarrassed you are, the better.
You're just trying to torture me here, aren't you? Very smart. It is a fine outfit.
Well, it was supposed to be yours. I still think you'd make a better Hokage than I will.
Well, it was a democratic decision. The villagers chose you. You are the Hokage.
Madara.
This stone has been passed down through generations of the Uchiha clan. It can be deciphered only by those with special eye abilities. This is as much as I can read so far. Seeking stability, there was a god who split into two halves, light and dark. Bringing the two halves together again grants the user the power of all creation. In other words, bringing two opposing forces together as one will lead to true happiness. But you can take it another way, too.
Huh?
Never mind. There is no point in talking to you about it now.
What do you mean?
Hashirama, I am leaving the village. We are history.
Why?
I do not have any allies here. No one looks up to me.
But I can't do this without you. I need you as my right-hand man, as a brother. The people will soon come to see you for what you are. And when they do, you can be the second Hokage.
I should think Tobirama will be your successor. If that happens, my clan will be doomed. I have tried to warn the other Uchiha of the danger and get them to leave the village. Save your breath. I am leaving. I have found another way.
Wait, they're just misunderstanding you.
Let us just say it comes down to how you perceive reality. Anyway, enough with the groveling. It is far healthier to see this world as a playground.
Hey, are you listening to me?
You are the only one who can stand up to me.
Mother!
Until I reach the path to my true dream.
Ugh.
I shall enjoy fighting with you.
What is your true dream? Why wouldn't you explain it to me?
Lord Hokage!
What is it?
It's Madara Uchiha! He's coming!
What? Really? He's come back?
He's attacking the village! He wiped out the vanguard unit. We sent a second and third, but we've had reports of heavy casualties. We're working on evacuating the villagers. We just can't stop Madara's advance. What are we going to do? Hokage!
What's the meaning of this? Why would...
Madara, we built this place together, you and me. Why would you? It doesn't make sense. I can't understand you anymore. I can't understand.
Ambitions and machinations swirled in the dark night. Had the emotions of yesterday already run dry? Was despair the only thing that awaited? With unspeakable pain in his heart, Hashirama Senju challenged his friend. Believing that in this deep abyss, there was one last sliver of hope.